Wow, that's a lot of games to have to carry around.
Fortunately, you can solve this problem by installing your games directly onto your SD or microSD card on your 2DS or 3DS system.
Grab your handheld and your favorite game cartridges. I'm about to teach you everything it takes step by step to get this done. And be sure to stick around to the end of the video because there's an important bonus about copying over your save games that you don't want to miss. With your game of choice inserted into your system, press the Start button and Power button together to launch God Mode 9. Turn your attention to the top display. From the list of choices, use the D-pad to scroll down until you get to C:GameCart and select it with the A button to continue. You'll be presented here with a handful of files. You want to look for the file that has the ending extension trim.3ds. Use the D-pad to move the highlighter down to that file and select it with the A button to continue. God Mode 9 should recognize the game you have installed. In this case, it's Kirby Triple Deluxe. Shifting your attention to the bottom display, select NCSD Image Options with the A button. In the submenu, use the D-pad to scroll the highlight down until you get to Build CIA from File, then select it with the A button to continue. This process creates an installable file for the game that you want to play from your SD card. In this case, it took about 6.5 minutes to complete. Once the CIA file has been built, you'll get a confirmation message on screen. Press the A button to continue. Now that your CIA file has been created, you can press the B button several times to get back to the God Mode 9 main menu and press Start to launch the main menu for the 3DS. In a very clever use of acronyms, CIA files are installed to your system using FBI. Launch it with the A button. Focusing on the bottom display, select SD card with the A button to continue. From the list of choices, use the D-pad to scroll the highlight down to GM9 and select it with the A button. Inside GM9, use the D-pad to scroll the highlight down to Out and select Out with A to continue. See that file listed near the top that has all those numbers and then ends in standard.cia? That's the game CIA file you created earlier. Move the D-pad down to highlight it and select it with A to install the game. You'll be prompted as to whether or not you want to install the CIA file or install and delete the CIA file. In this case, I'm just going to go ahead and install it. One of the benefits to installing and not deleting is that you can back up your backups on your local computer. Once you make your selection with A, you'll be prompted to continue, select Yes with A. It took about 5.5 minutes in real time for the CIA file to install, which is a great opportunity to go check out this custom gaming merch over at the official BlaineLocklear.com store, link in the description. Once the CIA file has been installed successfully, you'll see a confirmation message. Press any button to continue. At this point, you can close out FBI. Press the home button on your 2DS or 3DS system. Hey, do you like presents? I love them. And there's a present waiting for you on your home screen. Select OK to continue and you'll see your game waiting to be unwrapped. Select it with the A button and you'll see your newly installed game on your SD card ready to go. Press the A button to launch it for the first time. Hey, you remember that bonus tip I promised you earlier in the video? Here it is. Take a look in the bottom display. See how all of these save slots say that there's 0% completion? That's because it's new on the SD card exactly like it would be if you'd inserted the cartridge for the first time. No sense losing the progress from the game cartridge saves, let's fix that. Press the home button to go back to the main menu, and at the prompt select OK with the A button to close out the game. With your game cartridge of choice still inserted into your system, use the D-pad to scroll through the list of menu choices until you get to the listing called Checkpoint. Select it with the A button to launch it. Take a look in the bottom display. The game you have inserted is listed, and you specifically want to look for the word cartridge so that you'll know you're pulling this information directly from your cartridge saves. Select New with the A button to back up your saves, and at the confirmation prompt, select Yes to continue. You can choose to create a custom name for your backup save file or just click OK to continue. Once your backup's been created, select OK to continue. At this point, remove your game cartridge from your system and press the home button to close out Checkpoint and return to the main menu. The save games are backed up, but they're not associated with the copy of the game on the SD card yet. To fix that, press A to launch Checkpoint again. Now if you look in the bottom screen, you'll see that Checkpoint only sees game content on the SD card, not the cartridge. Press A to select your game, scroll down to the save game backup file, and press the right shoulder button. Press A to restore your games, and at the confirmation prompt, select OK with A. Press the home button, and then press X or tap on close to close out Checkpoint. To make sure your save games transferred from your cartridge to your SD card correctly, relaunch your game. Access the load game section of your game, and whammo! No more empty save game slots. And check this out. If you like this video, check out this video shown on screen and linked in the pinned comments and description below. And special thank you to these channel members shown on screen.